Greetings, everybody, and welcome to another episode of Cooking with the Duck of Indeed. This is the Five Nights at Freddy's official cookbook. I recently did a poll. Burgers got second place until another vote came in that tied it for first place with mac and cheese. First off, we gotta make Bonnie's Burgerlicious burger mix. Every awesome burger needs to begin with the basics. Get the meaty mix method and recipe right, and the rest is a piece of cake. Well, a piece of burger, actually. Ha ha. Knowing how to rock out with a meaty treat is always cool around the pizzaplex. Alrighty then, whatever you say. These burgers actually have onion rings in them, which sounds delicious. First, we gotta make the meat, though. Okay, I have this stuff here. In a small pan over low heat, melt the butter and cook the finely chopped onions. I do have the onions chopped up, right here. Finely chopped up onions. I have a pot that's way too big, but I'm actually like making kind of like multiple recipes and it makes more practical sense to have a big pot right now. So that's what I'm doing. Okay, melt the butter. First the butter. 1.5 tablespoons of butter. Okay, do that first. 1.5 tablespoons. It's right around there. There you go. This is the butter. Get that in there. I got the butter in there. I need to melt that. Melt the butter and cook the finely chopped onion until soft. Make sure not to add any color to the onion. Remove from the heat and leave it to cool completely. So many directions. Okay, we got this meat. I can put that in a bowl at least. They want 600 grams of ground beef. At our store, they're usually selling it in 450 gram packages. So if my calculations are correct, it's going to be 1 1/3 of these. That should be roughly 600, so... Hi, Carmelita! My kitty cat Carmelita is meowing again. Hi, Carmelita! Her and Rosie. I know Carmelita! Her and Rosie actually got some new toys recently, and they're very excited about it. Carmelita's a lot more talkative when we get her new toys. We also got them an extra tall cat tower, and Rosie likes to climb up on that. She clings to it like a squirrel, and then she climbs to the top and sits there. Sits there like a tiny queen on her little throne. Carmelita! Let me just get this in the bowl. I may as well do that while we wait for the... Oh, the butter's melting. The butter is melting already, so we got some of the meat in there. Okay. Oh, it's making noises. Low heat. Okay, I should have been melting that over a low heat. I melted it over a higher heat. No wonder it melted so fast. Okay, let's get those onions in there. I can't show you guys some of this stuff right now. It's low heat. Low heat! Alright, I'm cooking the onions. It's sometimes difficult to adjust the camera. Today the camera's been kind of funky, so I kind of don't want to move it because it's been hard enough to get it to the right spot. I'm gonna say that's about a third. That should be the 600 ounces I need. Okay. Let's get that in that bowl. It's over here. Mix the meat and onions. And then you add the seasonings and stuff. So I think we could probably do that. Oh, leave to cool completely. Sure? Okay, well, apparently I can't add it yet. And why don't I just add the seasonings? I have to let the onions cool completely, apparently. Okay, let's just add the seasoning, I guess, for now. 1/2 teaspoon of garlic powder. 1/2 teaspoon onion powder, which I think is really weird because... I think it's weird because we're putting in onions. Why do we need to add onion powder? I almost never use onion powder anymore because I usually just put onions in things. 1/2 teaspoon black pepper. How much salt? 1 teaspoon of salt. Okay, 1 tablespoon of Worcestershire sauce. This is the sauce everyone always jokes about that's hard to say the name. Worcestershire. I don't know. Shake well before using. Okay. Shake it. Okay, 1 tablespoon of that. I have never had this in my life, but they want it, so I'll do it. I will do as I'm told. I obey the rules. I'm a rule follower. I ain't a rebel. Huh. I need to get that lid off, probably. Tablespoon. Kaboom! Okay, let's mix that up while we wait for the onions to cool.
And mix up this beef. Now do the onions. Apparently I have to wait for them to cool. Do I really have to wait for them to completely cool? Do I really? Are you sure? Hopefully they'll cool fairly quickly. I don't know. But yeah, I used an extra big pot because I have reasons. I'm going to need it, so.
Okay, so we're back. So the onions have cooled. We're going to add the onions, and then we add 1 egg yolk. I had to check that. Mix well using your hands, and then divide into 4 even portions. This is the onions. They look pretty good. But yeah, this pot is way too big. I was going to be cooking onions in this pot later. So, I just thought, why not Why not use the same thing? And then, yeah, an egg yolk. I have to do just the egg yolk. So I got this, like, plate here. Maybe I can try to get the egg whites onto this plate. I will try to do that. Maybe I'll try to do that. Let's see. Okay, there you go. Oh, no, not the yolk. Okay, so we got this. I'm just gonna yeek. There. Stay in there, egg yolk. I'm holding on to the egg yolk. It can't come out. Oh, the goo! We gotta get all the goo! Apparently I don't want the egg whites. What do I do with this egg white? Ah, the egg white's going to waste. Oh, there's so much goobers. There's so much egg goobers. No, I don't want the egg. I don't know. We pretty much got it. There's the egg yolk. Get the egg in there. I'm already messy and disgusting. It's like I may as well just mix it with my hands now.
Pop the egg yolk. Pop it. Oh, yuck. No, I have to mix it with my hands. Ew. I should just... I'm gonna set this aside. This plate's disgusting over here anyway. Okay. Gonna mix in the egg yolk, the seasoning, the onions. It's disgusting.
So for the burger recipe, I'm making 2 burger patties. The rest I'm actually gonna use to make nachos. I'm actually doing a lot of cooking. Okay, I think it's mixed pretty good. I need to divide it into 4 even portions. Maybe I can... I don't know how to do this. Maybe I can make them into like 4 balls, and if they're like an even size, maybe? This is a small one. This is very small. Okay. This one's little. That's a lot of onion. It's okay if some of the onion goes to waste. It's totally all right. I like onion, but just a little bit goes to waste. It's fine. Okay. Okay, you guys can't even see this. Here it is. We got 4 meatballs. Okay, so now that we've made the meat, I set that aside. I haven't flattened it out yet. We're supposed to work on the sauce and the onions first, but let's first read the official description here. Bonnie's ultimate burger with crispy buttermilk onions. As a lead guitarist, it should be no surprise to see Bonnie leading the way with instructions on making the ultimate burger. Whatever you say. If you top it with the crispy coated onions, you'll be striking all the right chords once again. They try to make it relevant. It never quite works. I got the sliced onions. I already have some onions sliced up for onion rings. I have way too much, but I kind of want to make some extra onion rings because onion rings are delicious. They're one of my very favorite things. Let's see, place the sliced onions into a bowl with the buttermilk and leave them to soak. I'm going to actually do like the dry stuff first just because it'll be a little easier with the spoons and stuff I have. So let's do the dry stuff first real quick. The dry stuff is going to be flour, paprika, and salt and pepper. 2 tablespoons of flour. It's possible that I'm going to end up needing more batter because I have a lot of onion rings, but we'll just see what we can make. This is a real full tablespoon, but 1 teaspoon of paprika. Teaspoon of paprika. And then just whatever salt and pepper they feel like. I have so much stuff here. I have so much stuff I gotta juggle. There's stuff everywhere. Paprika. Tiny bit of salt. Pepper. Okay. Okie doke. Let me just mix that up real quick. Mix that up. I don't know how many onion rings we're really gonna make with this. I'll make what I can, but like I said, I'll probably be making a whole bunch later for myself when I'm not recording. Okay, that's that. I'm confused why my phone says 38 minutes at the top. Because it should have a lot more hard drive space than 35 minutes. Why is it telling me 35 minutes? It's making me nervous. Okay, how much buttermilk? 3 tablespoons. Why is it coming out like that? Wow, that was disgusting. I've used buttermilk before. I don't remember it being... Oh, that's gross. That's gross. I'm doing more than 3 tablespoons. It's fine. I don't think that's going to make much of a difference. Ooh, it smells weird. It smells weird. Is that really all I need? I'm going to put more than that in. Okay, so I just did double the buttermilk. Kind of more than double. Get those onion rings in there. At least we'll get a couple in there. I don't know. There's really... How much are you going to be able to soak in there? Here's my onion rings. They look very cute. I chopped them up ahead of time. Are you guys sure about this? You know what I'm gonna just do? I'm just going to put in some onion rings and then pour some buttermilk over it. I feel like I'm gonna need more of the dry batter too. Maybe I'll do that. I got small rings, I got big rings. I got all kinds of different rings. Okay, let's just do like that. Let's do something like that. I'm not doing this exactly right. It's just, I know I'm gonna need a lot more than this. And I don't wanna be in the middle of frying onions and need to get more. Gotta make the sauce after. I have never actually fried anything before. Okay, now we're gonna make the burger sauce. Got a container I'm gonna put it in. It's literally this like ice cream container. They have nice little containers you can reuse. It's like this gelato stuff. Ketchup, mustard, and mayo. And it said gherkin. Also, they want chives. That's an optional thing. I'm not doing the chives. But yeah, they said gherkin. People were saying that in burger sauce, you usually want a sweet pickle. So I have a sweet pickle. I will be chopping that up. Let's do the other, let's do the liquidy things first though. I already used up the tablespoon for the buttermilk, so I got this for the mayonnaise. 1 teaspoon ketchup and 1 teaspoon mustard. There you go. Mustard, yum yum. Okay. Pretty easy to make if you want to make more. Mustard. Gonna turn into a probably a light orange sauce if I know my colors correctly. This is what we got so far. Okay, let's chop up a pickle. Chop up a pickle.
Chop up this pickle. I have chopped it up in small pieces. Okay, I'll try. But yeah, the 30 is weird. The 38's not going down or anything. Why is there 38? What does it mean? This is ominous. I don't know, like, stop recording, is it? I hope not. I'll have to, like, delete. I'll have to make space. If there's a problem, I'll have to, like, delete stuff in the next room. Okay. Chop this pickle up into small pieces.
I don't know if this is chopped finely enough. These are pretty big pickle chunks. I feel like these chunks are too big. Let's get them in our container. Yeah, let's... I'll scoop them in here. With this. Okay. Are you guys seeing this stuff? It's sometimes hard to get things in front of the camera just right. Okay. I don't think I chopped it as well as I should have. Is this gonna be enough sauce? I'll just do what they say. All right. Mix it up. I really think the pickles are too big. I think the mayonnaise overpowers everything. I thought it was gonna turn like a nice light orange. Though I guess in the picture, it kind of just looks like this color. It's a very, very, very light orange. That's our sauce. To fry the onions, heat the vegetable oil in a small saucepan or frying pan over medium heat. Yikes. I'm scared about that part. I got the wet stuff, we got the dry stuff. And it's gotta go in the oil. They said 5/6 of a cup of oil, which is a weird amount. I just did a bunch in a pot. I thought that made a little more sense than 5/6 of a cup. That just doesn't sound like enough. I have a plate set up with paper towels, and the onions are gonna go on there to drain. I don't even know if I can show you all this though, because there's so much stuff to look at. I've adjusted the camera, I still can't really see the oven too well. I'll try to show you guys what I can. And also, it's weird because I deleted even more off the hard drive of my phone, and now the number's gone down even more, so hopefully everything is recording properly. Also, I have tongs. I have tongs for picking stuff up, so we gotta put heat over medium heat. Oh, that is so weird. On the oven, the thing that's like heating up, the burner thing is like purple. In real life, it's red, but in the video, it's purple. That's so weird. Why is it purple? Yeah, I'm just doing this so I can stay cleaner, and I can put these into the oil without getting my hands really close to it all. Okay, so I'll just fry up what I can. I always wanted to make homemade onion rings. Onion rings are one of my favorite things. Forget French fries, onion rings are the best. But you can actually use that buttermilk for soaking chicken before you fry it also. Makes it juicier. I've got this for scooping it out. I'm gonna have to put it on the paper towels. This is gonna be difficult. I'm gonna have to put the paper towels somewhere. There is so much to do here. So much. This is getting messy and weird. Got a nice little pile here. It's not a whole lot. They're getting just weird and lumpy now. The buttermilk's getting into the flour and making it all lumpy and weird. And then I gotta wait for this oil to heat up. It's taking a very long time. Yeah, so to test that the oil is hot enough, dip 1 or 2 pieces of onion into the flour, place into the oil. The oil is hot enough if the onion gets crispy after about a minute. Okay. The oil is hot. Do we test it or not? So I got my paper towels. Do we sacrifice an onion ring? Do we sacrifice this weird lumpy one? No, the oil is definitely not hot enough. Nothing happened. I just decided we may as well chop up a few things while we wait for the oil to heat up. So they're going to want tomato slices and pickle slices. I have sweet pickle for the sauce, and a dill pickle is what I heard you should have, like, in the burger. So cut off the butt first. Cut off the butt. We're multitasking.
Got ourselves a nice, delightful tomato. I've already given it a good rinse. So yeah, let's just slice up some tomato slices while we wait. And then we'll be ready to hopefully assemble that burger immediately. Get everything out that we're going to want. I also have some cheese. Let's see, yeah, I don't have lettuce. Who wants lettuce? Who needs lettuce in your burger? I don't want to spend money on lettuce. But I do have some cheese. I found out this is a really thick one, but I don't know if I can really get it thinner, can I? No. I'll just put this one aside. We froze some block cheese so it wouldn't get old, because block cheese seems to always get moldy really fast once you open it. So we froze it so it would stay fresh, and then we took it out recently to slice it up for the burger. Apparently, if you freeze block cheese, it gets really, really crumbly.
I got a whole bunch of pickle slices and some tomato.
I can't believe it. You're incredible.
Okay, is it time to cook the onions yet? Let's find out. Let's do the sacrificial onion. This is the one that's already been in the oil. Yeah, I can't show you guys super good. I'd have to turn the camera more, and it doesn't do this angle super good. Oh, I think it's doing it now. I think it's doing it. Okay, it's cooking. I can't really show you guys, but it's cooking. You can kind of see. It's cooking in there. You can't see it super good, so it takes about a minute. I got this to get it out of there. Oh, I'm scared. It's cooking though. It's like, I wish I could show you guys better. You can kind of see it right there. It's right over there. It's cooking in there. It takes about a minute to cook. Okay. Oh, it's dripping. It's kind of weird. I mean, a lot of the batter fell off, but let's try that now. Let's try to do more of that. Oh, it's still popping. Okay, let's put more in. It's 10:09. I'm doing this so that I don't get burned. I'll just do a group of them. I'll do a group. Oh, it's scary. It's scary. Doing a whole bunch now. Okay. Okay, I think there's a couple stuck together here. Okay. There's a whole bunch. I'll just do that for now. I should actually use the time on the camera to know when it's been a minute next time. That would actually be more accurate. I'm gonna go with it. It's kind of quieting down now. Oh, they're all like in a bunch right now. That's fine. That's what we got. This guy's been left behind. He's okay though. He's free now. We have rescued him. We rescued the straggler. Okay, this is kind of fun. And also scary. Some reason the camera stopped recording. I don't know why. I better keep an eye on that. Okay, I had to actually leave for a bit. So I ran out of space on my phone's hard drive, even though I deleted a whole bunch of stuff. So apparently, I didn't even know, on this particular phone, there apparently is a trash area where all your deleted stuff goes, and it doesn't delete for 30 days. So I had to go find that area, delete a whole bunch of stuff that should have been deleted already. I should have a lot more space now. I don't have the, like, countdown anymore, so I think I have more space to do this. Okay, so we just finished the onion rings. I was pretty much able to show you guys. We're gonna cook the burgers very soon. I just kinda wanna try one of these real quick. I'm just gonna try one. They look pretty good. Pretty tasty. A lot of the batter fell off, but they're delicious. I love onion rings. They're one of my favorite things, and I would give them a 10 out of 10. But for now, it's time to make the burgers. Okay, heat a frying pan to medium heat. Medium high, okay. Would that be like a 7 then? Maybe? It's just a meat. It's turning kind of brown for some reason. I haven't squished them into patties yet. I should probably do that now.
Make it into a patty? Okay. Okie doke. Cook the burgers, heat a frying pan. So they're gonna want... Okay, it's not sticking together. I don't know. It's not sticking together. I gotta make sure it sticks together. It's not gonna be good if it breaks apart. I know, it's kind of a patty.
They also want you brush the patties with vegetable oil. I don't think you really need to do that. There's already plenty of fat in these. I don't think I need... I think I'll spray them with Pam. But I think brushing them with oil is like overkill. I don't know. Hopefully this is okay. I've never made burgers before. Hopefully it'll turn out fine, because the onion rings turned out fine. They were actually kind of fun to put together. It was scary but fun. But yeah, so before I cook the burgers, place the open buns face down in the pan, toast until lightly browned. Okay. We had 2 burger buns left. They were in the freezer until recently. They are nice and defrosted now, though. Open buns face down, toast until lightly browned. You guys see that? Making myself 2 burgers. One burger's for the video, another one's just gonna be a bonus burger. Okay, but yeah, well, I'm not gonna brush the patties with vegetable oil. Oil seems like overkill, but we got Pam. We can spray them with Pam. Why don't we do that? I'll just spray them with Pam. I'm gonna do it now. I'm impatient. That's good. Oh, it is starting to brown. I don't know how well I can show you guys. It's starting to brown, though. It's toasting. It's toasting a little bit. I'm trying to show you guys as much as I can. Try to multitask here. Get 3 in there. Are you guys lightly toasted yet? Kind of. Oh, this one's very lightly toasted. This one's, I don't know. I think that's good. I don't know. This isn't too bad. This is fairly relaxing. I'm glad that things are back to normal with my videos. I was so confused. I thought I was deleting. Oh, this one's really. That's fine. This one turned out kind of weird. Cook for about 3 to 4 minutes. I'm probably not gonna. I have some weird bonus meat. It just didn't stick. Okay. Stick it in there. Oh! It's making sounds and it's scary. Put some Pam on it. Oh my gosh. Oh my goodness. Oh, it's falling apart. One of them's falling apart. Using the base of a saucepan to flatten them. Okay. I'm trying to squeeze it. They make noises. The one's falling apart. 3 to 4 minutes. I'm literally gonna just. I'm just gonna put this upside down. That's what I'm using to squish it down. One's falling apart, unfortunately. One is doing okay. One's falling apart. They said medium high. Should I flip it now? I don't know. Are you guys seeing anything? Let me see. Let me move these around so you can better see the nice one. Oh, one's falling apart. Oh no. Whoa. Oh no. Oh no. Oh my gosh. They're burning. I'm gonna turn the heat down a little. Are they supposed to be like that? They're so crispy. The cheese, the weird cheese. Oh my goodness. This is a bigger piece of cheese. Okay, I put some cheese on. They're really plump burgers. They're very plump. Are you guys seeing this? Are you seeing this nonsense? Man, they said 3 to 4 minutes and I should have listened. I think I did more than 3 to 4 minutes. They're very crispy now. Burger. Other one. Okay. We got ourselves 2 burgers. I gotta get that stuff off the heat. Okay, 2 burgers right there. Let's start assembling this. Okay, so what order do they want me to do stuff? Spread the bun with some burger sauce. Which one's the bottom bun? This is the bottom bun. There's a bottom bun. Burger sauce. I probably need more burger sauce for the other burger. Got some burger sauce. Still recording, right? Okay. That's a lot of pickle. I'm gonna totally need more of this. I'm gonna need more of this for the other burger. Whoops. Okay. Made a little bit of a mess. Burger sauce. Okay, I'm just probably putting on too much, but I want it to cover the bottom. Lettuce and tomato. I'm not doing lettuce. Got tomato though. There's a nice slice of tomato right there. Burger, crispy onions. Oh, more burger sauce. I don't have much more burger sauce. I put it all on the bottom. Okay, my very crispy burger. Okay, more burger sauce. There's not much burger sauce. When do we do the pickle? Yeah, now I do the pickles. Add some pickles. This is going to be a tall burger. Pickles. Crispy onions. Look at this nice big onion ring. It's like an onion halo. It's an onion halo. This is going to be a tall one. I'm going to put there. Three right there. More burger sauce. I don't have much burger sauce left. And then we will be trying this. I'm not going to stab it with a knife like they have. They have it stabbed with a knife. I'm doing the best I can here. That's what we got. It's going to be a good burger, though. It looks good. Okay. Wow. Here is our burger. Oh, my goodness. Look at this. Look at this burger. This is absurd. I put way too much sauce on the bottom, and it's like small compared to the bun. It's a crazy-looking burger. How am I going to eat this burger? But you got those onion rings in there. You kind of see some of the cheese. Also, we got some onion rings as a side. Let me get some of those guys over here. Delicious. All right, got ourselves a nice side of onion rings. Onion ring burger with a side of onion rings. All righty. That is a nice plate of food right there. Okay, I'm intimidated by trying to eat that burger. I'm intimidated by it. I'm gonna try some onion rings again. They're a bit old now, but onion rings, yeah, onion rings are delicious. Onion rings are always 10 out of 10. They're not super special onion rings, but they're nice and crispy. The onion's soft and the batter's kind of crispy, what actually remained. There's not tons of flavor to the batter, though. Probably could have used a little more flavor, but alas. This is a crazy burger. I think this thing is humongous. Okay, I gotta try to eat this thing somehow. Hopefully it's not cooked on the inside. We'll see. If I try some of the burger sauce by itself. Yeah, the burger sauce is good. Like I said, I think it's kind of like ketchup with like kind of like the tang, the kind of zingy tang of mustard. It's also a little sweet, probably because of the sweet pickles. The burger's good. I don't even think I've gotten to the onion rings yet. It's just hard because it's so big. But yeah, the burger is nice and crispy on the top and bottom, which I do like. I would prefer a more well-done burger, but I mean, yeah, it's a little pink on the inside, which is fine. But there's so much going on, it's kind of hard to taste every single thing. I don't taste the tomato. I don't really taste the onion ring. Pickles are real good. Definitely recommend putting in pickles. I think the pickles are really good in there. I did dill pickles for the regular pickle slices and sweet pickles for the sauce. It's a real good burger, though. It's the best burger I've had in a long time. Yeah, I mean, I would recommend it. I'm gonna maybe just give it a 10 out of 10. I think it deserves a 10 out of 10. It is a delicious burger, and I want to go finish eating it now and end this video. The cupcakes got third place in the poll. You guys will be seeing that next. Thank you so much for watching. As usual, don't forget to visit us at virtualbastion.com for more gaming goodness. Goodbye, and you're welcome.